Hello. This question is asking us to integrate the function x squared over root 4 minus x squared from x equals 0 to x equals 1. To evaluate this integral, we need to make a substitution. And we have two choices for this type of question. Because the integrand has the expression root a squared minus x squared, we can either use the substitution a sine theta, or we can use a hyperbolic function, a times the hyperbolic tangent of theta. My recommendation to you is, because you're more familiar with the trigonometric functions, is in tests at least, to use the trigonometric substitution. So I'm going to make this substitution on the side. I'm going to let x equal 2 sine theta. Calculate the derivative. And because this is a definite integral, I need to change the limits of integration. When x equals 0, I have sine theta equals 0, so theta is 0. Similarly, when x equals 1, sine theta is 1/2, so theta would be pi on 6. That allows me to rewrite my integral as follows. I have the integral of 4 sine squared theta over the square root of 4 minus 4 sine squared theta. And it's very important to replace the expression for dx with 2 cos theta d theta. And replacing the limits of integration with 0 to pi on 6. Our next task is to simplify the denominator. We recognize that the 4 comes out of the square root as a 2, leaving us with 1 minus sine squared theta. So the denominator will simplify to 2 cos theta. And that, of course, allows us to cancel 2 cos theta from the numerator and the denominator. This simplifies our integral considerably, leaving us with the integral from 0 to pi on 6 of sine squared theta d theta. The next task is to evaluate the integral of sine squared. For this, we have to use our double angle formula for cosines. I'm going to write that result on the right. We have sine squared theta is 1/2 1 minus cos 2 theta. And this is a result you really need to be comfortable using, because it comes up quite frequently when integrating trigonometric expressions. So I can rewrite my integral incorporating this half here as 2 times the integral from 0 to pi on 6 of 1 minus cos 2 theta. Which allows me to then integrate making sure that I leave in the limits of integration. So evaluating this gives me pi on 6 minus 1/2 sine 2 times pi on 6 is sine pi on 3, which is root 3 on 2. and subtracting the substitution of 0 in for theta, I'm going to have 0 minus sine times 0, which is 0. Simplifying allows me to say this is equal to pi on 3 minus root 3 on 2. And we're done.